Welcome back to WION Wallet. After the break, now straight to our special today. General Motors last week announced it will stop selling cars in India. That was a big breaking coming from a big auto major that was based in US, came to India in 1990s, and it's nearly shutting its shop here. So GM had to stop selling cars in India, and it will now only focus on producing cars, also R&D and other technical issues. To talk more on this subject, we are joined by our guest for today, expert for today, Mr. Jagdish Khattar, who is a former CMD of Maruti Suzuki and also CMD of Carnation Auto. He started his entrepreneurial journey few years back and is doing very well over there as well. Sir, first of all, we would like to know from your side, what went wrong with General Motors in India? Why they had to take such extreme step here?
I think several things went wrong, unfortunately. You know, General Motors was number one till Toyota took over, and now Volkswagen has taken over. They were one of the first to come to the country. They came with the JV. JV was with Hindustan Motors 50-50. 4 years later, they took their share. And then they came with a JV with the Chinese company, SAIC. And then they took over that. Now, you know what happens? When you have so many changes, even in the corporate structure, you are not able to plan a long-term strategy because every partner brought their own cars along with them. And therefore, there was a confusion. If you recollect, General Motors in these 20 years has introduced 20 models, starting from 3-4 lakhs to 30 lakhs. And each came, they introduced, it didn't do well, they withdrew and brought another one. I mean, the customer doesn't get confidence with that sort of a thing. So they had a problem as far as their whole product strategy was concerned, could be of various reasons, as I mentioned. Number two, I think they had a problem even at the CEO level. In 20 years, they've had 9 CEOs, average of 2-2.5 years. You know, I've always said, automobile is a marathon race. So if you convert that, it's like a test match. But if you have a CEO for 2 years, it becomes like a T20, and it doesn't work that way. So, and then you get expats, they take time to settle down. Before they settle down and understand, they make a move. Also, you know, it's a very hierarchical institution. The India CEO never reported to Detroit. They reported to the Asia Pacific office, I think it was Shanghai or Hong Kong. And the CEO would be going there every month for some committee or the other, not with the dealer network. So the point I'm really making is that there were so many things in terms of product, in terms of strategy, in terms of CEO, things kept on going wrong and losing the customer confidence. So I think ultimately they came, and meanwhile, they created huge capacity. They had one in Gujarat, the other one is in Tajola in Maharashtra. So one in Gujarat, they are selling it to the Chinese. But redeeming feature is that having created capacity, they will continue to produce and export. With a giant like GM, with so much network across the world, it's not difficult for them to export 100,000 cars or something to keep on going. And it's also very fortunate that they'll continue with their R&D, technical sell, etc., and sourcing from here. And as we understand, the pressure really came from the investors. You know, share price, you have mentioned about Ford just now. Same is true for GM. Their share price has not gone up. And I suppose the investors put pressure on them that you better start showing better performance. So they closed it in India as far as domestic market is concerned. They're closing it in South Africa.
So if you see a pattern over here, we can see that the Japanese and Korean automakers, they understand India well, while other side, if you see Ford, which is again a US-based auto major, it's a one product wonder. The second is General Motors. Do you think there's a problem in mindset also of these automakers? Because when it comes to dividing these car makers, we can easily see Toyota doing well in India, Suzuki, Maruti Suzuki is doing very well, is the largest car player. Korea is Hyundai and Kia is coming now. So is there a problem in mindset also as far as the east and west side of the world is concerned?
I mean, when you talk about Korea, don't forget that Daewoo came and left. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
absolutely.
So they also failed there. And Kia is yet to come, remains to be seen. Yes, I think Hyundai has done very well. And their whole strategy, they followed, I think, meticulously. They started with a small car and gradually went up. But do keep in mind, when they came to India, that was a time when Suzuki and Government of India had a problem. And for 3 years, Maruti was making no movement and getting ready for competition. That gave space to Hyundai, and they did a fabulous work in that 3 years to establish themselves. Now, coming back to your point, yes, the Korean is only Hyundai so far. One is left, and the other is. Japanese is, I mean, let's face it, Maruti with 47-48%, Hyundai with 15-16-17%. When two people dominate and get 65% of the market, very little is left for the others. And they have really to work very hard to get the appropriate models. They get the entire range and the network. It's an uphill task. So yes, Japanese have done well because Japanese have always been known for fuel efficiency and cost, which is extremely important in India, and residual value. And there, I think Maruti has played a big role in having your true value, giving support to the second-hand cars. Yes, Japanese and all have done well because they came on time. Their approach is very different. Many a time they listen to the Indian customers, and that's why they've been able to do well. But let's face it, that the two major players with 65-70 market share, life is very difficult for the others.
So in between, we understand that GM had a problem with Tavera, their one vehicle, where, you know, there were probes started because of scam and all. Was that a point, you know, where it started, or would you say that all this was going on from long time?
No, I think that's where I think they got a big knock. And Tavera was one of the vehicles which was doing very well. And I think coming of Tavera, and earlier was the Toyota car also, mm-hmm. which came. They came at the time when our BPO industry was expanding. Qualis. They were doing. And Qualis was, believe, you know, it was a car which was mothballed in Thailand. They closed. They brought it in India and made a success out of it. It's good luck to them. Yes, your answer is that Tavera had a knock. And that was a car which was selling the most. After that, all other models that they brought, and less, you know, last 10 years, 8 years, they've been bringing Chinese cars. No, China is different. The, you know, philosophy of manufacturing, quality, they are so very different. And you confuse your dealers. I mean, what will the dealer say? Astra, Opel first, and then you come to Chevrolet, American, European, then Chinese. There is a consistency. And you get demoralized because very difficult to explain to the customers.
Fine. Thank you, Mr. Khattar, for talking to us and bringing all details for our viewers. Mr. Khattar, is last word when we talk about cars and cars positioning in India. Clearly, General Motors has taken a very big step, and he explained what was the reason behind this. With this, it is time to wrap this edition of WION Wallet. For more news and updates, stay tuned to WION, and thanks for watching us.